What are the latest investment trends affecting ETFs? Exchange-traded funds are a fast-growing part of the fund investment industry. ICI economist Shelly Antoniewicz took a look at the data and shared some key takeaways about where investment money is flowing.
We're on pace for another banner year in ETFs. So right now, year to date, we have about $300 billion in net share issuance in ETFs. That already exceeds the total for 2016. We're heading into the fourth quarter. Fourth quarter is usually a very strong quarter for net share issuance in ETFs. So I'm really anticipating that we're going to have another record year.
And so then let's take a look at the categories. Where is all of that money flowing?
Well, it's pretty broad-based across sort of our main categories, which would be domestic equity, international equity, and bonds. So we can, you know, talk about each one of those individually. In the international equity space, what we saw this year was a resurgence in demand for international equity ETFs. Last year was pretty low. This year we've seen it return and there's been much more demand. Now, I guess it's not too surprising. That's probably in response to the very strong stock price increases that we've seen in international equity markets. And that is probably likely related to the improved outlook for economic activity worldwide.
And let's also talk domestic then. What do you see on that front with domestic equity?
Domestic equity is having another strong year this year. One category that's been growing exceptionally has been large cap. And again, probably not too surprising, large cap stocks have their stock price gains have been outpacing small cap so far this year.
People are always interested in what's going on with bonds.
Yeah, bond ETFs again, another strong year. They're on pace for a record year as well. So each year they've been increasing in demand. One thing I think that has helped sort of bolster that demand in bond ETFs this year has been there's been continued returns to bonds for investors. And things that might normally rattle the bond market, we haven't materialized this year. The Federal Reserve has indicated that they're going to continue to have policy be a slow, gradual process where they're reducing the accommodation, and they've said they're going to well telegraph that to the market in advance. Inflation, which is another issue which could spook bond investors, that outlook has been very subdued.
So no one particular spike, really strong across the board.
Yes, all three categories are very strong. We've seen investor interest in international equity first, domestic equity is second, and bond ETFs, but none has so far outpaced the other.